Hi guys, this is Dan from the Investment ABC, and in this video I want to talk about the correlation between interest rates and property prices. Is there really a correlation, and if yes, what does it mean for property prices in the future? I have three charts for you next to each other. The first one shows the RBA's cash rate back from 1989 to now. The second one shows the peak to trough declines in the Sydney property market. And the third one helps you to visualize and understand the second chart better. We are comparing now each peak to trough decline with the change in interest rates over time. Unfortunately, the cash rate chart starts in 1989, but I pulled out the number for the overnight cash rate from the RBA site, and we can see that rates increased from 1984 to the end of 1985, and from there declined back by the end of 1986. We can see that the sharp increase of the cash rate led to a 9.5% decline in property prices from 1984 to 1985. The second decline started in 1988 and ended in 1991 with a peak to trough decline of 11.6%. Let's see what happened with interest rates during that time. The RBA increased the cash rate from approximately 11% in January 1988 to a peak of around 18% by the end of 1989. This sharp increase led to a recession in September 1990, which lasted approximately 1 year. We can see that the RBA started to cut interest rates aggressively when they spotted the recession to around 8.5% by December 1991. The RBA kept decreasing interest rates further until they paused in July 1993 at 4.75%. So let's see when our next decline occurred. Looking at the chart, we can see that it started in 1994 and ended in 1995 with a smaller decline of 3.2% in property prices. What was the cash rate doing over that period? It increased from 4.75% in 1993 to 7.5% by the end of 1995. Our next decline in property prices started in December 2003 and ended in January 2006. With a negative 8.2%. The cash rate increased in 2002 from 4.25% to 5.25% by December 2003, and then increased further to around 5.5% in January 2006. After this 2 years stable interest rates environment from 2003 to 2006, property prices rose from January 2006 to March 2008 by 8.9%, while the cash rate peaked in the same period at around 7.25% in March 2008. Property prices fell from March 2008 to January 2009 by 4.6%. Interest rates were cut significantly from 7.25% in March 2008 to a low of 3% in October 2009 during the GFC crisis. Property prices kept increasing from January 2009 again to October 2010 by 15.8%. Interest rates kept increasing from a low of 3% in October 2009 to 4.5% by October 2010. And property prices declined 3.1% from October 2010 to August 2012. The RBA began to cut interest rate from a high of 4.75% in December 2011 to a low of 3.5% in August 2012. And from August 2012 to October 2015, property values increased by a whopping 42%, while interest rates kept declining to 2% by October 2015. From May 2015 to April 2016, the RBA kept interest rate at 2%. Property prices declined from October 2015 to April 2016 by roughly 3.5%. And after another rate cut in April 2016, the property prices began to rise again. The RBA decreased interest rate to 1.5% in August 2016, and property prices kept rising from April 2016 to September 2017 by 14.9%. Since then, Sydney house prices declined roughly 12% until now. Now we know for a fact that rising interest rates will eventually lead to property prices flattening or declining, while interest rate cuts lead to an increase in property prices after some time. We could clearly see that interest rates were falling in the long run, despite some ups and downs from 1988 to now, from around 18% to 1.5%. This decline in interest rates led to an increase in private debt and property prices. If we look at this chart, which displays the household debt to GDP ratio, we should ask ourselves what will happen when we hit 0% soon and the bond markets or inflation forces the RBA to reverse course again. Many people took and will continue to take on huge mortgages with variable interest rates when interest rates are at historic lows and prices are at unsustainable levels. Like I said many times in different videos, all markets move in cycles, even interest rates. When interest rates move into a long-term uptrend again, it will lead to declining property prices and in a deleveraging of debt. Even mainstream media and the Fed are worried about the recession in 2020 in the US, and China is already slowing considerably. The Australian economy won't be that lucky, like in the GFC, to not get affected by the next crisis. The opposite is the case. The high household debt to GDP ratio makes Australia very vulnerable to shocks. It is no surprise that the RBA kept interest rates stagnant for such a long time now. I think it is one of the longest periods so far. They are in a very dangerous situation right now because Australia's interest rates are historically higher than in the US. But now, since the US Federal Reserve began to increase rates since 2015, capital is flowing out of Australia into the US and weakened the Australian dollar. If the US is still tightening or keeping rates flat and Australia is lowering interest rate further in 2019, the Australian dollar will tumble even further. So in my view, it is going to be very hard for the RBA to decrease rates in March 2019. I think they will start doing so after the Fed started to decrease rates again. I am not sure by how much the decline in Sydney property prices could be dampened if the RBA cuts aggressively to 0%. We saw that historically declining interest rates led to a further rise in private debt and property prices, but the debt level is reaching more and more critical levels. Even if they trigger another debt-driven leg up in property prices, after that the fall will be even worse and from higher levels. If you haven't watched my forecast for the property market in 2019 to 2020, I will link the video at the end of this video here. Everyone should prepare for hard times and eventually debt deleveraging. I don't give any financial advice. Everyone should do their own due diligence whether I'm correct or not. But I would definitely not touch a mortgage at this time, but rather try to pay off my debts and position myself defensively. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. Hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell and share when you have friends or family who think property always increases. Thanks a lot, guys, and see you soon.